Hello everyone, welcome to Jagran Public School Noida. In this session of class 10th physics, we will discuss about our light chapter. This is part 7 and in this part we will discuss about the refraction of light. Till part 6 we completed the reflection term or the reflection part of mirror and spherical mirror. Now in this part, we will start the refraction. So let's start. What is refraction? So refraction is again a phenomenon of light. When the light rays either bend or change their direction while passing from one medium to another. Means light always travel in a straight line in a same medium. As soon as the light propagate from one medium to another medium, it changes its path or it bend. So when the light bends, when it passes from one medium to another medium, like the light travels from air into the glass and from glass into the air or from air into the water. Or from water into the air. Any path, if the light travel, it will bend. Because in all these cases, light travel or changes the medium. From glass into the air means the light travel in a glass and then it comes into the air. These are the example as you have all watching in your day-to-day life that when the light enters inside your house from the window pane. Window pane is made up of glass. So as the light enters inside, it bends and again inside your room, it start traveling in a straight line. Look at the diagram. In this diagram, if we put the pencil or pen inside a tumbler full of water, you will observe that the pencil looks like that. So this is due to the refraction of light. Means the pencil looks just little away from the straight line. Originally it is coming from this and in the bended position from the water. If we are looking at the pencil, it looks like the light is not traveling in the straight line. So the light bends. There is some phenomenon or some process through which the light bend. Means how the light bends when it travel from one medium to another medium. Refraction through the glass prism. Let's take the example of glass prism. Okay. This is simply a glass. Prism means a glass slab. A thick glass slab. When the incident ray, this one, when the incident ray strike the glass slab, it will bend. At the point of incidence, this, it will bend and it will bend towards the normal. Just suppose if the light passes straight like this and it bends slightly. If the light travels straight, it passes like this. But see the condition of light. It is not in the straight position. The red line shows it bends. And how it bends towards the normal. So when the light travel from air, that is written, this is air, inside the glass, it bends towards the normal. Next, the light ray passing from glass into the, from air into the glass or water are called incident ray. So this is incident ray. Next ray, when the light ray bends after passing into the another medium, they are called refracted ray. So this ray is called refracted ray. The ray B, OB is the refracted ray because it bends from its original path. Normal is the point of incidence is called normal. Normal, that is dotted line. This is normal. It's an imaginary line. Angle of incidence, the angle which the incident ray make with the normal is called angle of incidence. This angle I is called angle of incidence. Angle of incidence or any angle should be with the normal. It should not be with the glass slab or with the object. Okay, so incident angle is the angle which the incident ray make with the normal. Now angle of refraction. So angle of between the refracted ray and the normal is called angle of refraction. This one, angle of refraction. So there is, this angle is called angle of refraction. This angle is angle of incidence. Both the angle is with the normal. Okay, just look the figure properly. Both the angles are with the normal. So the angle of refraction is either smaller or greater than the angle of incidence. Means this angle, that is angle of incidence, this one may be bigger or greater than the angle of refraction. The case, how it is bigger, how it is angle of I is less than angle of refraction. Let's look at the next slide. First of all, what are the causes of these refraction? Why the light bends? Means you have seen in this slide that the incident light, when it's just propagating inside the glass slab, it bends towards the normal. What are the cause of that refraction? So the light travel in different speed in different mediums. For example, light travel faster in air than in glass. So the speed of light in air is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. That is the speed of light in vacuum as well. And due to the change of that speed, so as the light travel from one medium to another medium, the speed of light changes. Why the speed of light changes? Because the density of each medium is different. So the speed of light, now the conclusion is that the speed of light depend upon the density of the medium. So air is optically having a less density, or we can say air is an optically rarer medium in which the speed of light is 3 into 10 to the power 8. Now comes to the glass. We will say like that glass is an optically denser medium than air. As compared between air and glass, we will say air is an optically, word comes when we are talking about the light. So we are talking about the propagation of light. So we will say, yes, air is an optically rarer medium. So when the light travels in air, its speed is 3 into 10 to the power 8. As soon as the light enters the glass, its speed changes, or the speed become less, because the glass is optically denser than the glass. What is optically rarer medium? As we discuss, a transparent substance, means medium through which the light can pass, that should be transparent. It should not be opaque. Through opaque, we will study, or that already we had studied before, that there would be a reflection when the medium is opaque. And when the medium is transparent, then there would be a refraction. So a transparent substance in which the speed of light is more is called optically rarer medium. More means 3 into 10 to the power 8. That is the speed of light. And rarer medium is basically it is in air. And the transparent medium in which the speed of light is less than as compared to another medium is called optically denser medium. So in the above example, glass is an optically denser medium than air. And if we are comparing glass with water, then also glass is an optically denser medium than water. And if we compare glass and water, just leave the air, then water is an optically rarer medium and glass is an optically denser medium. So the rarer and the denser compared with the two medium which is given. If the medium is water and glass, then in that case water is a rarer and the glass is a denser. And if air and water is there, then air is a rarer, water is a denser. So we will always compare between the two medium. Now, what are the rules for refraction of light? Just look at the diagram. Here it is, an air is written. This is air and this is glass. Okay. So the light rays which are coming from the air just propagating inside the glass. So again, this is incident ray. The ray which gets inside the transparent medium is called refracted ray, which bends. The ray which bends is called refracted ray. And just look at the figure. Air is called rarer medium. Glass is called denser medium. And the ray of light, this is red light, bends towards the normal. It slightly bends towards the normal. So the conclusion is that when the ray of light travels from optically rarer medium to denser medium, then they bends towards the normal. In this case, angle of, now look at the angles. Just see angle I and just look at angle R. Which angle is greater from the figure? Angle I is more than angle R. Okay, this angle is more than angle R. So in this case, when angle I is more than angle R, this is only the case when the light travel from rarer to denser medium. Example, when the light travel from air into the glass or from air into the water, it bends towards the normal. This is because, and the reason of this, because the speed of light in air is 3 × 10⁸. As soon as the light enters another medium, denser medium, the speed of light decreases. And as soon as the speed of light decreases, obviously it bends, or the speed becomes less, so it bends towards the normal. And again, after bending, it travels in a straight line. Just look at the figure. Light always travels in the straight line in a same medium. In an air, it was traveling like OA. And as soon as it enters the another medium, like it glass, again it starts traveling in a straight line, but it bends from its path. Okay, that is clear. Now, just move to the second case, the opposite of that. For example, the light coming out from the glass. There is a transparent glass. And in the first light, as you put the pencil inside the glass, when you look the glass from the bottom, you will find out this way. So when the light travel from optically denser to rarer, means the light is coming out from the glass, right? When the light is coming out from the glass, means now this become incident ray, and the light which is coming out from the glass become the refracted ray. So incident light is this light, and the refracted light is this one. This is the refracted ray. Now look at the figure. From the figure, the incident angle is this. This become the angle I, which the incident ray make with the normal. And this become the reflected, or the angle of refraction, R, which the refracted ray make with the normal. Now, which angle is greater from the figure? It is shown that angle R is greater than the angle. This angle R is greater than angle I. So when this happened? This happened when the light rays travel from optically when the light ray travels from optically denser medium to the optically rarer medium, then they bend away from the normal. You have to remember this. So when the light travels from denser to rarer, it moves away from the normal. And when it travels rarer to denser, it moves towards the normal. Now, when the light ray travels from glass into the air or from water into the air, they bends away from the normal. Again, from glass into the air, glass is denser, air is rarer. And from water into the air, again, the water is denser and the air is rarer. They bends away from the normal. In this case, the speed of light increases. So why it bends away from the normal? Because the light bends away from the normal because the speed of light increases. The question can be asked like that. Why the light ray, refracted ray, move away? When the refracted ray move away, this shows that the speed of light increases. As soon as the light comes out from the glass in the air, again the speed of the light become 3×10⁸, which was before. So it move away from the normal. Now, again, case of light going from air into the glass and again into the air. Just look at the figure that we did before. This is a glass slab, okay? Again, the incident light. Incident light coming and from air to glass, rarer to denser, it move towards the normal. This dotted line shows if the light moves straight, it may be like that, but this is not happened. The light bends towards the normal. As soon as the light reaches the point B, that is interface of two surfaces, glass and air, then again it bends and it bends away from the normal because the light travels from denser to rarer medium in this case. So in the first case, the light rarer to denser towards the normal. Now denser to rarer away from the normal. And when we mark the light, incident light, if it travels straight, then it should be like this. But this is not happening. So what will happen? The light shifted from its path. That shifting is called lateral displacement. Okay, that when the light shifted from its path means that path, this is called the lateral displacement. It appears that light travels straight, but light doesn't travel straight if it passes from one medium to another, that is density has been changed. And this phenomena we already did in case of twinkling of a star, that is the same case because the light travels with different density of air, the light refract. So in this case, incident ray and the emergent ray. Emergent ray is the ray which is emerges out of the glass slab. So in this case, incident ray, that is our the ray which is incident and the emergent ray which is coming out are parallel to each other. If we make a parallel, they are both parallel to each other. And the perpendicular distance between the incident ray and the emergent ray called the lateral displacement of the emergent ray of light. And the angle which the emergent ray making with the normal is called angle of emergence. So in the glass experiment, angle I is always equals to angle E. Means in this case, if you will see the diagram, this angle I should always be equals to angle E because both the lines are parallel, but there is a lateral displacement. That's why anything which is immersed in water appears slightly displaced from its position, slightly above the surface, slightly bigger from its original shape. This is again, all is due to this lateral displacement. means if you put a coin or a lemon inside the glass of water, you will observe that the coin is little above from the surface and the lemon will appear little big from its size. Why this is happen? Because of this lateral shift. Means the incident ray and the emergent ray, which is parallel after coming out from the glass, there is a lateral displacement between the two rays and the things appears little displaced from its position. So whatever you are looking inside the water, the position of the object is not real. It is a virtual position because the light is getting refracted. So when the light ray traveling through air enters the glass slab, they get refracted and bends towards the normal. Now the direction of refracted ray changes again when it comes out of the glass slab into the air. Again the direction changes means at the last the direction changes means emergent ray again away from the normal. First the refracted ray towards the normal, emergent ray away from the normal. This shows that the direction of the light changes again and again when it is propagating in different medium. So this is all about the refraction and your glass slab experiment. So next is light falling perpendicular on a glass slab. What will happen when the light is falling perpendicular? So the when light falls perpendicular on the glass slab means light is traveling on the normal. It goes straight. So why it goes straight? Because the incident angle, which the incident ray, which is making an angle with the normal, is zero. So when the angle I is zero, the angle R would be zero. And if the angle R would be zero, there would be no refraction. So when the light falls perpendicular on normal on the surface of the glass slab, it goes straight. There is no bending of ray of light on entering the glass slab or coming out from the glass slab. Angle I is always equals to angle E. Angle I is zero, angle R is zero, so angle E is also zero. So in all the case, this the same happen if the ray of light falls perpendicular on the surface. So the ray of light without refraction passes through the glass slab. And when this condition happens, when the light ray fall perpendicular on the normal, when the light passes through the normal. What is the effect of refraction of light? This is an stick, the first example which we have shown in the first slide, and the stick should appears like this. Means this is the original shape of the of your stick, but it appears like this. Why it appears like this? Because of refraction. The light ray which is passes from air to water, rarer to denser, the light ray bends. When the light ray bends from your eyes, the image, original image is this, but you are able to see this image. Means when you are looking the object, you are looking at this image. That why the stick appears bent from this position. Refraction of light, and when we hold a stick obliquely and partially immersed in water, it appears to be bent at the surface because of refraction at this point. And due to the refraction, the stick appears bent from its original position. So this is the phenomena. An object appears to be raised when placed under water. This is the phenomena of refraction. Pool of water appears less deep than it actually is. This is again due to refraction. If a lemon is kept in a glass of water, it appears bigger when viewed from the sides of the glass. From the side, it appears bigger. When you look just bottom from the bottom of the glass, it appears like a same size. Why? Because the light coming from the normal, and if the light coming from the normal, it will not refract it. So it is due to the refraction of light that star appears to twinkle at night. These all four points are the phenomenon of refraction that we observe daily in our day-to-day life. So this is all for refraction. Just go through the slide properly and I think you are able to understand the topic refraction very well. Thank you all and have a nice day.